Today we're going to look at estimating a square root. The question asks, find two consecutive whole numbers that the square root of 29 lies between. So let's do a little bit of vocabulary first. Consecutive means right in a row. For example, 2 and 3. Those are consecutive numbers. We want whole numbers, and we want two consecutive whole numbers that the square root of 29 lies between. Now it helps if we know our squares and square roots. So I've got this handy little table hidden here for us. The square root of 1 is 1. The square root of 4 is 2. So for example, 2 times 2, 4. 3 times 3, 9. So the square root of 9 is 3. 4 times 4 is 16. So the square root of 16 is 4. 29 lies somewhere between the square root of 25 and the square root of 36. So the two whole numbers that 29 lies between will be 5 and 6. Remember, what we're looking for is the square root of 25, which is 5, and the square root of 36, which is 6. And the square root of 29 will be somewhere between those two numbers. If I plug the square root of 29 into my calculator, I actually get 5 and 38 hundredths, roughly, 5.385164807, etc. And that really is between 5 and 6. So the square root of 29 is approximately, rounded, 5 and 39 hundredths. So that does lie between these two. Let's take a look at another example. Two consecutive whole numbers that 85 lies between. Without looking at our chart, we know 9 times 9 is 81. So the square root of 81 is 9. And we know that 10 times 10 equals 100. And the square root of 100 equals 10. And so the square root of 85 is somewhere in between there. So it's between the two whole numbers, 9 and 10. Let's see if we're right with our handy chart. Square root of 9 is 81, 100, yes. Find two consecutive whole numbers that 122 lies between. Well, I know 10 times 10 is 100. I know 11 times 11 is 121, so it's got to be more than that. It's somewhere between 11 and 12. And that would be our answer for estimating a square root. I hope this helps you with this particular topic.